And this guy just gave me a 20-minute dissertation about Holst and his pieces and St. Paul's and the girls' school and
amazing.
Yeah. I think he's a college ringer. They just bring him in. That's not fair to give them a college. He's basically a Norway Shakespeare. So we think of this great playwright, somebody that all of the kids study. So you're going to have some reading assignments and some essay assignments on both if you're a Norwegian school. The cool thing is he lived 200 years before Grieg did. And at the time, they were going to celebrate 200th anniversary of his birth, and so they looked around for the most famous Norwegian composer. It's going to be Grieg, and they asked him to write a piece. And the olden style that you're talking about reflects back to the Baroque period. So we have these movements with dance titles that really haven't been in vogue, haven't been in fashion for a century and a half. But Grieg is bringing that to try to recapture the feeling of that time. The music is very modern. It's the modern piece of music, but he does kind of reference those Baroque dance moves. You guys play the mute, I'm just going to throw out some suggestions, since that's why I'm here, since that's very peanuts on the airplane. the yumpa is a huge part of this. It's, I think even the basses, it's so important even the basses get to do it. You know that's important. Okay. So can we just play that figure, that Hasidama figure. First finger, E. So on your D string, on your favorite D string, first finger, E. Just play yum, bada, yum, bada, yum, bada. Ready, and. Good. So the placement in the bow is going to change depending on the dynamic, depending on what's happening dramatically in the piece. But for now, we just decide middle of the bow. This is going to be smack dab in the middle of the bow. Ready, aim. The challenge is how long do we make the eighth note? Okay, I want you to make the eighth note extremely short. Make it sound like a 16th. Morse code. Ready, aim. It's a little Rossini-esque, isn't it? Can you make it legato now? Make the eighth note legato. Ready, and. Take a Norwegian square dance. Okay, good. So I think it's somewhere in between. It'd be easy to play everything really short. It'd be easy to play really legato. But I think the clarity, the drive, the rhythmic drive, the excitement is going to come from somewhere in between. So can it be slightly detached? Yum, buddy, yum, buddy, yum, buddy, yum. So longer than 16, but shorter than maybe the 8 that's right. Here we go, last time. Ready, and. And just monitoring that as you go. As things get loud, the orchestration gets deeper. Just kind of monitor that motive. Always there. Here we go, Bird again. Did we talk about breathing on what's in? And you've stopped breathing? I haven't seen you for 72 hours and you've stopped breathing? It's amazing you're here. Okay. Can we breathe? You mind if we breathe? Coughing is a sign of breathing. That's excellent. I was about to say it's a clean air day in Pittsburgh, but now I'm not so sure. There we go. We'll breathe together. And I mean, everybody has to breathe. Everybody has to breathe. Especially if you don't feel it. Here we go. Excellent. Terrific. Very good. Now, why is breathing important? Besides the physiological. Yes, sir.
Breathing, like, let's all start together.
done something together as an ensemble. That's pretty cool. And it's one of the few things that I as a conductor can do with you. I can't make a sound of you, but I can breathe with you. What does breathing, I love that answer, what does breathing communicate? What are some musical things that it can communicate?
Accents.
Okay, the style. Excellent. Yes, sir.
Beginning with a phrase or the moment, or other the moment, right before the beginning of a phrase.
Okay, an entrance, important entrance, right? Because all the answers are coming from the basics. Everybody else would be like, so basics.
This is like the oddest, the bizarro world.
Good job. How about tempo? Okay, so the obviously the speed of the breath is going to influence how fast you play. Dynamic. Versus. Okay, I mentioned style, accents, articulation. Lots of stuff. That's why, and it all happens before you make a sound. You do that together. It's my breathing. Oh. I woke up in the hotel this morning, I was breathing, I knew it was going to be a good day. The very beginning. We have to get softer there. We got to make sure that the previous section, the previous piano, is not too soft. Not too soft. So we've got to have somewhere to kind of disappear to first person context. Good. So plan ahead. Cellos and basses. Obviously, these pizzicatos, you're doing them in tandem. Because we have such a full and quality bass section, I would say cellos play up. Technically, you're playing a piano and it's right, but it's overbalanced by the basses. And it's such a warm, wonderful sound. I hate to back those guys off. So, a little more of your pizza. Next. This is A, letter A. Allegheny. But it's still can't let that happen. Okay. So can you find a way to crescendo? of a rhetorical question, but not really. All right. Excellent. This is letter A one more time. Cool. Okay, so hold that thought. This is bad teaching. This is bad teaching. Hold that thought. Hold that thought. For 5 minutes, can you one thing? Real good. Look at her leaning forward. This is kind of a concert master. Yes. Okay. We start right at the PUPM, so it's about 6 after 8. We'll take the pickups. Just the first 5 minutes. 2, 3. That's the one. That's the one. That last quarter. First of all, it's a quarter. It's not an eighth note. And yes, there's a staccato down on it. But if we make it too heavy, it takes away from this charm. Your setup is so beautiful. You kind of slide this out of this reverie. So you just push it off and into the form. That seems about puking. Better. I still feel like that note needs to do the line. It's too heavy. It's too heavy. Light as possible. It's like tinker bell perfect. Really, really light. 2, 3. Yeah! That's it. Never have you ever met. Okay, that was good. That was still a big lunge at Olive Garden. But that was so much better. That was so much better. Okay, so we're okay on the stuff that we're thinking about. We're not going to rush. Okay, we're not going to rush. Keep those last two bars. And go ahead and take on to the next section. Those of you really familiar with the score, did you see the interesting thing that Mrs. LaBelle did? So this is the page 2. I think you were here for Suhan's section. This is the devilish page 2 that scared me. So Grieg ends, has everybody just occupy a beat. So at the end of that beat, you're done. Mrs. LaBelle said it's going to be a little bit easier both to stop and start if there's a conclusion, if you conclude on the beat. So she has stretched each figure just into the downbeat, so that rather than being isolated and then a new start and then a new start, you pass the baton off to the next section. I think it works well. I'm taking